press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, we have been studying about the chapter soil. Okay, and in the previous class we have studied about the soil profile and its different layers, that is different soil horizons, that is O, A, B and C. Okay, and in today's class let us see about the soil types. Okay, so we have different types of soil. Okay, so what is soil basically? Soil is the mixture of rock particles and humus. Okay, so soil is made up of weathering of rocks, that is rocks break down to form soil. Okay, so the soil is mixture of rock particles and humus. So what soil contains? Soil contains rock particles, small rock particles, and also humus. Humus is nothing but the remains of plant and animal waste. Okay, the remains of dead and decaying plant and animal waste. So that also we can see in this soil. Okay, so the soil is basically the mixture of rock particles and humus. Okay, and why do we have different types of soil? Okay, why can't we have the same soil everywhere? Okay, the soil is present everywhere, that we know. Yes, it is a natural source on the surface of this earth, right? So, but why there is a different types of soils present? Okay, so because the soil is made by the weathering of rocks. Yes, that we know. And these are different rocks. Okay, different rocks lead to the formation of different soils. Okay, so that's we have different soil in different regions. Okay, and here we have different types of soils because this type is basically based on this proportion. Okay, so the types, okay, so the soil types whatever we have, that is basically based on the proportion of particles. Okay, so proportion of soil particles, yes, of course. So what is proportion here? Proportion is something, you know, here in this context, proportion is how much or how much amount of small and bigger particles of soil we have. Okay, so based on the size of soil particles, okay, whether the soil, all the soil particles are big or all the soil particles are small, well, whether the soil contains both big and small particles in equal quantity. Okay, so the based on the proportion, that is how much or how much amount of bigger and smaller particles the soil has. Okay, so the how much amount of bigger and smaller particles the soil has. Okay, so the based on that we have basically three types of soil. Okay, and those three types are sandy soil, okay, clayey soil and loamy soil. Okay, so in this class we will study in detail about these three types of soil, that is sandy soil, clayey soil and loamy soil. So as I mentioned, soil contains, yes, soil particles, rock particles, right? And there are big rock particles, small rock particles, etc. So based on that big and small particles the soil has, there is this classification. Okay, and here in sandy soil, okay, the first type of soil, that is sandy soil, here we have more number of big particles than small. Okay, for example, see, here is the big soil particles. Okay, it's not like soil exactly contains these structures. Okay, I'm just drawing it so that you can understand. Okay, here we have a big number of these soil particles. Okay, big size. Okay, the size of the particle is big, and here the soil of particles is small. Okay, but here you can see the big soil particles are five, right? I'm mentioning again that this is not exactly how soil looks like. Okay, I'm just drawing so that you can understand easily. Okay, in the sandy soil, in the very first of soil, Here in sandy soil we have more number of bigger soil particles than small. Okay, so here see, big soil particles we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we have 5 big particles than small. Small particles we have just 1, 2, 3. Okay, in this sandy soil we can see more number of bigger soil particles than smaller ones. Okay, so this is the basic idea of this soil types. Okay, based on the size of this soil particles. But here we have, okay, this clay soil is opposite to this sandy soil. Okay, in the clay soil we have more number of soil particles, small soil particles, okay, and less number of big particles. Clear? In clay soil we have, you can see we have 5 small particles and big particles we just have 3. Okay, so here in clay soil we have, as you can clearly see, we have more number of soil small particles. Here we have less number of small particles. Here the particles are very big. Okay, here we have more number of small particles than big particles in clay soil. This clay soil is opposite to the sandy soil. Okay, and here in loamy soil, this is intermediate between this sand and clay. Okay, this loamy soil has, yes, it has equal number of small and big particles. Okay, it has 3 big particles and 3 small particles. Okay, so this loamy soil has equal proportion. See, the proportion of big and small particles is same. Okay, so the proportion of bigger soil particles and smaller soil particles is same in loamy soil. Okay, but the proportion of small soil particles is greater than big particles in clay soil. It's opposite in this sandy soil. The proportion of small particle is lesser than big particles in sandy soil. Okay, so this is the, on this basis we have differentiated between these types. Okay, now let us see about this sandy soil. Okay, yes, sandy. Okay, the term sandy soil is nothing but sand. Okay, so where do we find this sand? Yes, in deserts, right? There is exactly where all the soil is sand only, what we usually have, right? So we all have seen this sand, right? So sandy soil is nothing but the sand. Okay, and this soil is well aerated. Okay, so this sandy soil, as we have seen earlier, it has more number of big particles than small particles, right? And because of that reason, okay, this is well aerated. Okay, so if we are having these small particles, okay, it will be kind of, you know, arranged in this manner with less air spaces. Okay, but here in sandy soil we are having more of big particles. Okay, and since we are having more of these big particles than small particles, so if we are having small particles somewhere here, okay, and here, we can clearly see there are large spaces here, okay, large place, right, these are the air spaces, right, okay, so we have, no, arrangement is not that tight, okay, though it's not compact, it is kind of loose, okay, the arrangement is not that compact or it is not tightly arranged, and hence we can see air spaces, okay, so hence it is a well aerated soil. Yes, and since it is well aerated, it does not retain water, okay. This soil do not retain water. Okay, so you might have seen, okay, you can just try it out in your home. Okay, take some sand, put water. Okay, does it absorb, does the sand absorb water? No, the water just flows, right? It does not absorb, it does not retain the water. Because the particles in the sand are something like this, right? We have discussed this. It has big particles with more, you know, just small particles somewhere here. Okay, so it has more number of these big particles, and there are, it is well aerated. Okay, so when we are watering it, okay, so when we water this soil, okay, since these particles are not close enough or it is not tightly arranged, the water just flows off. Okay, they drains off. Okay, water just flows from here or somewhere here because there are too much spaces present here. Okay, there is no soil present in there to absorb the water. Okay, so the whatever water we pour in it, it just drains out. Okay, the water drains away. Okay, see, somewhere from here or here, the water just flows off. Okay, so hence this does, since it is having very low retaining property, very low retention of this water. Whatever water we pour, it just drains off. Okay, and since, okay, whatever water we put, okay, whatever water we pour to this soil, it do not retain the water, and water just drains off, which makes this soil very dry. Okay, so that is the reason deserts are very dry, the sands are very dry, there is no moisture, it is very hot to touch, right? So that, because it is does not retain water, which makes the soil very dry. Okay, since it is dry, the soil is very light. Okay, very lightweight. Okay, when we weigh the sand, it is very light compared to the normal soil. Okay, it's because, see, it is not having any water, right? There is no retention there, it does not absorb water. Okay, when we do not have water there, it is just soil particles. Okay, that is the reason it is light. See, for example, when you have some dry cloth, okay, when you have dry cloth, it is very light, it is not heavy weight. Okay, it is very light to lift. Okay, when it is dry cloth, the same when you pour it in water, when you wet the cloth, it is very heavy to lift, right? So you can just hold dry cloth in one hand and hold some wet cloth in other hand. Okay, we can clearly see, we can clearly observe this, the wet cloth will be very heavy than this dry cloth. Same way, when there is no water in this soil, okay, it does not retain the water, this soil has only soil particles, and because of this reason it is dry, and since it is dry, it weighs very light. Okay, so this sandy soil is very light in nature, and it is not suitable for plant growth. See, because plants, you know, plants needs, the basic need of plant is the water, right? Not only plants, all the living organisms' basic need is water only. Okay, but this soil, the sandy soil, does not retain water. The water we pour, it just drains off. Okay, when the soil, when the sand itself is not having water, how can the plants grow there? Right, so the plants, basically they need water. Okay, there are some exceptions in some plants where they can grow even with less amount of water. Okay, that's the reason we can see a few plants in desert region also. Okay, but most of the plants, almost all the plants needs water. Okay, so all the type of plants cannot grow in a sandy soil. Okay, because they need water, and we find very low water in this sandy soils. Okay, so it is not suitable for this plant growth. Okay, so this is about the sandy soil. Okay, so this sandy soil is well aerated because there is presence of more number of big particles than small, and due to this presence of big particles, there is more number of spaces present there, and due to that spaces, whatever water we pour, it do not retain water, the water drains off. Okay, hence the soil is very dry and light. okay, and because of this reason we cannot find any plant growth there, okay, except some exceptions. We do not find all the plant growth there, okay. It's hard for the plants to grow in this sandy soil since it does not retain water, okay. So this is about the first sandy soil. Now let us see about the next type of soil. That is clay soil. Okay, so as I've said, this is opposite to the sandy soil. Okay, so this soil is having more number of small particles than this big particles. Okay. And yes, since we have small particles, more number of small particles than the bigger ones, here the spaces are very less, okay, compared to sandy soil. Here we have less number of spaces, okay, and since it is opposite to the sandy soil, okay, whatever we have points we have studied in sandy soil, it is just opposite to that, okay. This soil is has very less spaces, due to which it can retain more water, okay. This is the heaviest soil, okay, because it can retain more water, okay. See, here we having more of small particles. Okay, here somewhere we are having big particles. Okay, so this is something what clay soil looks like. Okay, here we have more number of small particles than big particles. We have just some 1, 2, 3, okay, but it is composed or consists of more of small particles, okay. And here when we pour water to this soil, it retains or it absorbs more of water, it absorbs too much of water, okay, because it is having more of this small particles, okay. When we water the soil, this retains too much water because of the presence of more of smaller soil particles, okay. And because of that, it is the heaviest soil, okay. Because see, as I given the example about the clothes, okay, when we pour the cloth in water, okay, when we had wet the cloth, it weighs heavy, right? So the same way, when the soil is full of water, it weighs heavy. Okay, when the soil is full of too much of water, it, okay, the weight of the soil becomes heavy. Okay, so this is why clayey soil. Okay, clayey soil is the one which retains too much water. Okay, compared to even sandy soil and the other loamy soil also, it retains too much of water. Okay, so because of this reason, it is the heaviest soil. And this soil is suitable for plant which needs too much water to grow. Okay, so there are various types of plants, okay, which do not need water at all, like, you know, little amount of water is a lot for them, okay. But there are also plants which can grow even in intermediate water need, but there are plants which needs too much of water, okay. So for those plants, okay, for those plants, these soils are the best, okay. For the plants which needs too much of water, this clay soil is highly suitable for them, okay. So this soil is suitable for plants which needs too much water to grow, okay. And this is the soil, okay, the clay soil is the soil which is used in pottery, okay. Pottery means soil, we make these pots and everything, right? We have seen this mud pots, mud glasses, mud plates, etc. Okay, made up of this mud, made up of this soil. Okay, so these things or these utensils are made up of this clayey soil only. Okay, because this clayey soil has less pores. Okay, less pores, hence it retains too much of water. Okay, so this soil is very tight, okay, very compact in nature. Because of that arrangement, okay, because of that tightness or because of that compactness, we are using this soil to make these pots, glasses or anything. Okay, so this soil is used in making pottery. Clear? Because of the reason that it can retain more water. Okay, so this is about the clayey soil. Okay, this clayey soil has less spaces between the soil particles. Okay, it has less spaces, and because of that reason it holds, or you know, the arrangement of the soil particle is very compact, very tight. Okay, since it is very tight and compact, it holds too much of water. Okay, so that is why it is suitable for the plants which needs too much water to grow, and this clay soil is the one which is used in making pottery. Okay, so this is about the clay soil. Now let us study about the last type, that is loamy soil. Loamy soil is the intermediate between this clay and sandy soil, right? Sandy soil had more number of this big particles and clay soil had more number of small particles. But this loamy soil has equal proportion of both small and big particles. Okay? So this is intermediate between sand and clay. Okay, it is intermediate between sandy soil and clayey soil. Okay, it has equal number of, why is it intermediate? It is because it is having equal number of big and small particles, and this soil is the loamy soil is perfect for plant growth. Okay, in sandy soil plants cannot grow because there is no water retention at all. Okay, and in clayey soil there also all the plants cannot grow. Okay, there are only few plants which needs too much of water, only those plants can grow because it is having too much of water in them. Okay, so all the plants do not need too much water. Okay, plants need adequate amount of water. Okay, plants die when there is no water. Even plants die also when there is too much of water. Okay, so they need a required amount of water, and this soil provides them that. Okay, so this is because of that reason this soil is perfect for this all the type of this plant growth. Okay, and this soil also contains these nutrients, minerals, okay, which are very much needed for this plant growth. Okay, sand, silt and clay. Yes. Okay, so this soil, okay, and one of the reason that this soil is suitable for the plant growth, that this contains amount of this nutrients, minerals, sand, clay and silt. Okay, so yes, sandy soil we have studied. Okay, whatever the sand is nothing but the sandy soil, and clay is the clayey soil, we have gone through this too, and the silt. Okay, so this silt is the deposit. Okay, so silt is the deposit of soil particles seen in river beds. Okay, and size of this silt is between So the loamy soil contains more of this silt. That means the size is between, the silt size is between the size of the sand and clay. And silt is the soil which is not found, which is deposited, and it is seen in the river beds. Okay, so this is about the loamy soil. Okay, this proportion of sand, soil and silt may vary. Okay, in loamy soil we can see more number of or more proportion of the silt, and in sandy soil we can see more number of sand, and in clay soil, yes, of course, we'll see more of this clay. And in loamy soil we can find all these minerals, nutrients, both the sand, clay and more number of this silt. Okay, so this is about the sandy loamy soil and these properties. Okay, since it contains adequate amount of water, okay, adequate their water do not just drain off easily and it does not hold too much of water. Okay, so all these properties makes this soil very preferable or very favorable for the growth of these plants. Okay, so this is about this loamy soil. Okay, so these are the three types of the soil, that is sandy, clayey and loamy soil. Okay, in this class we have learned all these three types, that is sand, silt and clay. Okay, so let us see about the properties of soil. Okay, till now we have seen the importance of soil, how soil is formed and their soil profile and also the soil types. Okay, now let us see the properties of soil. So basically in this lesson we are going to study three properties, that is percolation of water, percolation rate of water, moisture in soil, also water absorption in soil. Okay, so these three are the most basic soil properties we are going to study in this chapter, that is percolation of water, moisture in soil and water absorption in soil. Okay, we'll study these properties in detail in the next class. Thank you.